Hello, and thanks for tuning in. And I am that nerd dad, Joe Williamson. Hey, look, every week I talk parenting, pop culture, and politics. Click subscribe. I really appreciate it.
So I've been divorced for a long time now. It's been almost a decade. I'm in a second marriage. I've been with my current and final forever husband for 8 years. And I think that, you know, in retrospect, it's very easy to see things when you go through some kind of trauma, any kind of trauma. When you get out of the ashes and you dust yourself off and you look around, it's very easy to kind of see things more clear. I think when I look at myself back in that time, it was very easy for friends around me or anyone around me to say, oh, you need to get out. You're miserable. This is it. You know, this is not working. And excuse me, my friends were very good about it. They didn't really push me, but I did see from watching other people go through divorce situations, because clearly there's something in the water here. A lot of people overstep their bounds thinking it's coming from a good place of you need to get out, you need to leave, you need to get divorced. And the reality is that to tell someone to do that, it's kind of a dick move because you're not living their life. I'm so sorry. Listen, it's all the Wordle talk that got me worked up. You're not the person who's going to have to hash out a custody agreement. You're not the person who's going to have to uproot your life and find a new home. You're not the person who's going to have to split up pots and pans and forks and knives. Like, all these things that you're not thinking about logistically, emotionally, physically, you don't have to worry about. So to kind of throw out there, like, you should just get divorced is a really shitty thing to say to someone who may not be ready to have that conversation. And it kind of goes into the most common question I get from people related to divorce and leaving a marriage is, when do you know that it's time? And the answer is, nobody can tell you that. You just feel it. It's like that cheesy thing people tell you when you're trying on wedding gowns. You'll know when you know. The same thing happens with divorce. I think you reach your threshold where you're ready to leave, and nobody can tell you before that, or should tell you before that, what you should do, because they are not going to walk in your shoes following that decision and then face all the collateral damage. And so I really have a trigger, and I'm hypersensitive to how friends around you treat you when you're in that moment. Because for me, when I look back, what helped me the most was the unwavering support, the unconditional love, meeting me where I was, knowing, okay, you're not ready to leave yet. I'm here for you. I have your back. Whatever, however long this is going to go on, I got you. You're good. Don't worry about it. You're already feeling this immense pressure about your marriage possibly failing. So to have people around you who are your inner circle basically tell you your marriage is failing, you need to leave, is a really, really immense amount of pressure that you don't need added onto already of a pressure cooker of a situation. All that being said, yes, there are abusive situations, dangerous situations where friends feel like they need to intervene. This is not that. This is your run-of-the-mill divorce situation that nobody really should have any say in. And you can give your opinions if they're asked for and have the conversations, but you really should never tell anyone to leave. You really shouldn't.
Thanks for listening. Damn.